Hello and welcome to Let's Play Dink Smallwood Mods. Got a couple more to do. This one's the green voice in my head, part one, which we should just admit and that there will be no part two or three, because this was released in 2003. And part two and three were never came out. The readme text basically just says Dink has gone from a hero into a silly boozer, and he wakes up in a strange land with no idea where he is. He thought he was in Kernson or heading to Kernson, and while he was in an inebriated state, he did a lot of bad things, and so our quest is to fix these things during this game. And the other thing is that there's a voice in his head, which I'm guessing is in green text, which tells him to smash barrels for some reason. That's basically the gist of the readme file, and plus, you know, bug fixes and such like that that you would find. And what else? That's really it. The game ends pretty much on a cliffhanger, unfortunately, but I've heard other than that, it is awesome, so let's check it out. Part 1 of 1, Hangover and Agony. Ah, my head. Oh god, why? The screen's locked. Where am I? Don't hurt us, little girl. I have never seen this part of Kernson Town before. Strange. The Smashing Barrels voice, SBV, says, I don't think this is Kernson Town. The cursed voice again. Will it ever stop? Let's talk to the girl, the voice says. Maybe she will help us. Get out of my head. Go away. Please. You know I cannot do that. Talk to the girl now and stop wasting our time. But you didn't tell me to break this barrel. The smashing barrel's voice. Yes, smash him. I love it. You are sick. Do you know that? Look what you made me do. Who cares? That was the last one, I promise. I will never, ever smash any more barrels. Oh, yes you will. I love smashing barrels. Yeah, right. You must be kidding, right? No. I made up my mind. I, Dink Smallwood, will never, ever smash any barrels again. How about this? You let me smash some more, and I tell you where you buried your sword yesterday. What? Hey! Where did I bury my claw sword? 29 barrels more, and I will tell you where. You little bastard. Well, 29 barrels, who cares anyway? That's the spirit. Damnations. Why do I always bury my claw sword when I'm drunk? Don't ask me, I don't know. I have smashed one barrel. Well, it's a start. So we have nothing, yeah. I'm hitting my very own chest. I wonder why. Yes. Oh, yes, the voice says. Spontaneously hitting things makes me feel good. But it won't open the chest. My treasure chest with all my strength, potions, and money. It's locked, and the key is gone. I wonder where I put the key. Damn, I can't remember anything from yesterday. The voice says, why don't you smash your barrel? Maybe it'll bring the memories back. Don't try to fool me. You always persuade me into destroying things. I wish you just could shut up sometimes. No, I want to help. I don't believe you. It wasn't I who got the great idea to buy all the liquor in Kernson Town. It wasn't I who got the great idea to drink all the liquor. So basically, it is all your fault that all our things are gone. That we are lost in some strange graveyard we've never seen before, and that we are still on the booze. Shut up! It goes through all this again? Alright. Oh damn, I hit it again. Okay. This rock is so ugly that I just want to blow it to kingdom come. Hello, little girl. Hello. Do you know where I am? In the old cemetery. No, I mean, where am I? Hmm? The voice says, he wonders where on earth he is. In which country? You see, yesterday he drank too much. Can she hear the voice? And today we woke up here, and this is not Stonebrook, right? Why don't you speak with one voice? That's kind of scary. Okay, so he's... Alright, shut up. Me? No, of course not you, the other one. Well, never mind, where am I? You're in Armand. Armand? Never heard of... Strange. What kind of place is this? Well, Armand is most known for the death tournaments and decay. Okay. My father wants to talk to you about the money. Money? Father? What? My father is in the bar just east of here. Go and see him. How will I recognize him? He wears gray, dirty clothes, always carries around a scythe. And the smell of alcohol follows him like his own shadow. Jeez. The voice says, money. Strange. Can't remember. Okay, I better go and talk to him then. Yes. Okay, we're unlocked. Save point. Hidden. I want to look around first, though. We got a dead pill bug. A pill bug has gnawed at the fence until it died. The fence looks kind of weak here. I can see some red apples on the other side. Looks tasty. If I had an hatchet, I could cut down the fence. Die, fence! Die! Barrel. You're looking at the barrel number 2. Never hesitate. More smashing. I have smashed 2 barrels. What's up here? There's something... Some kind of blue thing. Oh, I can go up there. I didn't realize that. 100 gold. Nice. Is that some of our money? What is this blue thing? Barrels. More smashing, okay. Oop, I went into the rock. Interesting up there. Another barrel, looks like a goblin home over here. Ooh. Oh, I thought that's the kind that increases. Never mind. This guy gonna fight us? Is that why that's there? Hello! Hello! What are you doing here in the wilderness? I'm looking for some bonkas to kill. With your bare hands? Yes, I had to sell my sword. That's bad. Yeah. Invisible barrier. Invisible. And you don't even realize you can go down here until you go down there. Just gonna look around a bit more. 10 gold, and I see these steps. Oh, that's what I was looking for. Interesting, okay. Hello? You meet the port guard. What are you guarding? Mind your own business. May I pass? No. Why not? Forget it. Come on. Forget it. I will not smash any of your barrels, I promise. Forget it? Is it funny to work as a port guard? No, it's not. Why not? Well, the payment is bad, and there are always some madmen that tries to hit me or break into my warehouse or both. So you mean fun, not necessarily funny. But the worst thing is that I have to guard two places at the same time. It's impossible. Which is the other one? A bookcase full of priceless Ming vases. Where? In a house near the Lord of the Game's castle. Maybe you should take a look down there. Oh no, you can't fool me that easily. Damn, he is clever. Get lost! I figured I could hit that one. What if I hit him? Just get lost. Alright. Oh, that's where we came out. Okay, cool. Wait. There's a barrel on the end of that island. Oh, that's... I can't get over there. Never mind. I wasn't on the island. Ooh! Mega Potion. Tree of Doom. Can I cross on this? There's more barrels. It's another night. May I visit the castle? Well, as you can see, the castle is heavily fortified with over 1,000 guards. It's got a moat, and here I stand with a huge and sharp axe. So what do you think? I guess not. Correct. Who lives in the castle? The Lord of the Game. The voice says, let us leave. I don't like this place. Hmm? Yeah, they can hear the voice. It comes out of my mouth, but in a different... Oh, voice. Oh, the king is here. So now I take on the title of Kingslayer. King Daniel? King Daniel? Never heard of. I am King Morgan III. What are you doing in this grove? I mean, shouldn't you reside in a castle or something like that? Yeah, yeah, mock me, you little bastard. My precious castle I lost to the Lord of all evil. Lord Cain, the Lord of the Game. I hate him. The Lord of the Game? What game? Ever heard of the Death Tournament? No? Ah, good for you. Any plans on retrieving the castle? Well, I sit here in my grove and make evil plots against the Lord of the Game. The basic idea is to force all in Armin to buy weapon licenses, which will make me rich. And then I will be able to buy back my castle. Ha 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 ha. Okay. Tall barrels. That one all in the middle of nowhere. Oh. Interesting. What's this? Raven's Towers. Green voice says maybe we should take a look inside and see if there's any barrels there? I didn't say that. I'm just gonna look around first before going any structures. Okay, I didn't mean to hit that. This increases, yeah, magic. That's not even a door. Alright. Hmm. 14 barrels. Hello. The voice says, it's only a bed. Books about hairstyling and manicure. Books about plastic surgery. Yes. Oh yes, spontaneously hitting things makes me feel good. I'm trying to talk to this guy. You don't look like much of a goblin, though you live in a goblin house. I know. God bless plastic surgery. Can you do me a favor? Depends. I'll give you 100 gold. Help this guy, a plastic goblin. Sure. What do you want me to do? Outside my hut, there was a portal to a strange place. Enter a cave and you will find a shining metal object. Return it to me. Seems to be easy. Why don't you do it by yourself? I'm very busy. Yeah, that's right. I'm very busy. Found it? No, I haven't left yet. Not yet. Oh, this? Alright, let's hit that later. There's a barrel back here. 15. What do we need? 30? I thought. I just stole a rake. Woohoo! I didn't know I can get that. A rake, no more, no less. And stolen, of course. Wait, what'd he say? Why did you take it, stupid? You will always get us into trouble. Relax. Oh, that's actual goblin. Bottles, but now booze. Useless. Take this, stupid liquorless bottles. Oh, they're bleeding. Well, that's wine or something. Aha, disgusting. It's not hitting me, but okay. Some evil bastard stole my rake. Tell him that you're sorry. Damn, that's bad. I am so sorry. Me too. I'll tell him I did it. Actually, wait a second. Before I do something like that, before I do anything rash, I know! I did it! What? I stole your rake! Woohoo! The voice says, please shut up. What? I hate you. Oh. Why would we sell it to him? That's bad, but you know what? I got a great new rake for you. Give it to me. Not so fast. 50 gold and it's all yours. Okay. Here you go. It's a good rake. I can tell you that because it looks much like my old one. Oh, jeez. What a coincidence. The voice says, you're evil. Please stop disturbing Urgle. Why? It's hard to hit stone with hammer and talk to human at the same time. Hard and confusing. I might hit you and talk to the stone instead. Ah, bye. Oh, I meant to. I was trying to talk to the stone. We sold the guy his own rake. I might come to regret that at some point. What do you want? Get some water, try to frighten the well, or drop a coin in the well. Give me some water. There is no water, I'm dried out. Drop a coin? Are you looking at me? No, I'm not. I know you're looking at me. What do you want? Ah, that's it, I'm leaving town. Ugh. Are we still drunk? I thought we were supposed to be, like, making up for things we did while we were drunk. We're still doing horrible things, though, right? What is this? Oh, that's just a flower? Hmm. Alright, we're gonna look around this town. Oh, I didn't see this barrel. They're hidden pretty well. Alright, the bar. Good place to start. I can see we smashed these barrels. Oh, we left one. Let's see what the town news is. I remember this place. Me too. Okay. I want to see the town news. Some kind of poster. I don't care to read it. Yes, spontaneously hitting things makes me feel good. 17 barrels. No, he doesn't smell right. Hey, go sniff on somebody else. Why are we smelling people? Hello, my friend. Do I know you? Well, we talked a lot yesterday. We did? I can't remember anything. We talked a lot. You bragged about how easy you will win the death tournament. I did? What tournament? The death tournament, of course. How do you mean death tournament exactly? Death tournament, the greatest tournament in Armand. 8 competitors. The first prize is 1,000,000 gold. That's a lot of money. And a 2-8 prize is? Death, of course. Death? Am I really involved in this? Yes. You signed up yesterday after you told me that you're the greatest hero in the world. Then you told me to bet all my money on you in the game. You mean that I actually have to do this? Of course. After all, you have signed with your own blood, haven't you? And if I leave this place now, and I mean now as in right now, then the Royal Guard of Armand will hunt you down. Anyway, the gates out of Armand will be closed until the tournament is over. Who will be my first opponent? Look at the town news sign on the wall for info about the competitors. I wasn't interested in that, was I? And hold on to that winner feeling you talked about yesterday. I bet all my money on you. Probably shouldn't have done that. So you are his wife, I assume. I hate you. Go away. I'm sorry about this. I really am. Leave us alone. Alright, let's check this. The 8 competitors of the Death Tournament. 1, Crazy Pig from Windermere. Crazy and dirty, but is he really a winner? 2, Old Evil retired from the end of the world, has killed stone giants all her life. I can beat those, I guess. 3, The Great Dragon Agash, a winner of many death tournaments. For the first time in the same tournament as Lord Kane, she says, it's all about the money. I really don't want to read the rest of this list. 4, The Leader of the Cast, mysterious and evil, but is he evil enough? 5, The Big Slayer, another competitor from the end of the world. Don't they fight all these? We asked, why are you in? And he says, I have always liked to meet new people, kill them, and eat them. What a funny fellow. 6, The Magician Flux, known for his ability to teleport and hit friends and foes from behind. 7, Lord Kane, a demon lord from the 8th level of hell. 8, Dink Smallwood, once a great hero who defeated Seth, but now more a simple drunkard. Will he be a threat to Lord Kane? Will he be a threat to anyone? No, he will not, he says. He will not be a threat to anyone because he will leave this place now. Good luck with that. Still have anything to say to these guys? Get out! Oh my, you're not very friendly. Why do I have to get out? You're the one who smashed all the wine barrels. Rajan told us. It's your fault there isn't a single drop of wine left in Armand. We have to stay sober, all thanks to you and your demons. The voice says, it was an accident. I accidentally fell down the stairs and happened to smash some barrels in the process. Accidentally fell on 50 barrels? Yes. Get out. How about this guy? Same? Okay. Hello. Go away. Please. Hey, what's up? Why are you so sad? Sad? I am not sad. I am depressed. I have never been like this ever before. I have never been like this ever before. It's terrible. You can't imagine. Oh. Why? Something very terrible has happened. Okay, tell me. Let's talk about it. It might help. I doubt it. Come on. Okay. Takes a deep breath. Today I returned from my 2 weeks hunting expedition in Old Armand. Okay. I passed the museum and the weapons and spell shop, and finally, I was home again. I met Rajan just outside the bar, and he told me. What did he say? He said that some maniac has smashed the entire wine cellar. There was not a single drop of alcohol left. Everything is gone. Okay? He sobs. The green voice says, wine cellar. Yes, the wine cellar. That was great. What? What a glorious moment, the voice says. What? You were there too? Oh, yes. Why didn't you stop him? Sorry, I have to go. I haven't talked to the bartender yet. There's nothing you can buy here anymore. Why not? Because you smashed all the barrels yesterday, remember? No, I did not. Yes, you did. The voice says, yeah. No, he is telling the truth. He did not smash anything. It was me, actually. Yeah, disguise your voice. Very funny. You're going to pay for this. Oh, jeez. Okay. People are not happy with us. Check this house. Ooh, what's this? A big blue crystal, the voice says. It must be worth hundreds of tankards of beer. Hello. Hello. I'm Dink Smallwood. I'm Eric, the town's cooper. The voice says, really, I truly admire your art. Thanks. I have to leave now. The voice says, no way. Oh, coopers make barrels, I think. Can't we also smash these? No? No. Welcome to Armand Town. The voice says, how does it feel to get drunk in one town and wake up in another? Shut up! Welcome to our museum. Step inside and take a look at our Ming Vases collection. We also have Death Tournament info brochures. Now let's go in here first, then we'll destroy the museum. Or, let me guess, it's already destroyed one. And me? King's Issue 345. Maniac frightens a well outside Merrint Town. The well just ran away, says the mayor when fighting back his tears. We can't get fresh water anymore. It's so terrible. Oh, jeez. So I'll get rid of the wine and the water. It was dry anyway. I'm sorry, but you have to own a weapon license in order to buy weapons. A license? Where do I get one? Ask the king in the grove. Alright. Oh, that's right. He has this racket he's setting up. I'm sorry, but you have to own a spell license in order to buy spells. Where do I get one? King in the grove. Okay, can't go through here. Alright. A museum. Pamphlets. A nice collection of Ming vases. Haha, just sherds. You'll be fired, stupid port guard. Oh, this is the other thing he's supposed to guard. Some papers all over the table and the floor. Uninteresting. Well, we're sober and we're still making trouble. Hi. You sell magic potions, I assume? That's right, 200 each. 200? I prefer to be weak. What's with this thing? House at the end. Mm-hmm. Want to sell something? Scroll down for more alternatives. Ask him what he buys. What kind of things do you buy? Mostly red apples and various tools, but not rakes. Got it. 30 gold for a nice red apple and 100 or more for a useful tool. Why not rakes? The voice says, because the market is flooded by cheap rakes these days. Why is that? Mainly because there are many stolen rakes put in circulation. Okay. A table. Just splinters. A lot of houses here. Thank you. This might be my money that I'm just leaving laying all over the place. Might. Just splinters! Just splinters! There are several islands south of Armend. Here's a book, Witches and Such. Open it, the voice says. The witch Pomperiposa is known for her poison brews. She's a very mad witch living in the dark wood forest in a gingerbread house. She likes to eat children. What are you doing in my house? I don't know. Obviously, I'm destroying your stuff. Ooh. What we got in here? This rock is so ugly that I just want to blow it to kingdom come. Oh, can we get a bomb, maybe? And I can get this stuff. If I remember.